Okay, good morning students. In the previous class we derived Rydberg formula, that is what is a spectral line and what is the energy of electron in the nth stationary orbit, what is the wave number, what is the frequency, what is atomic spectra, what is the spectrum produced by hydrogen, we discussed in the previous class. And the last we have given one formula for wavelength of the spectral lines, so that is also called as Rydberg formula. In last class we have given, that is a Rydberg formula, 1 by lambda is equal to z square into r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. So in last class we have given this formula. In this formula, z represents atomic number and r Rydberg constant. Generally for a hydrogen atom we can write a Rydberg constant symbol as RH. For any other atoms generally we can represent R infinity also like this. So generally we can write a hydrogen atom means RH we can write, or simply I am writing here R. And N1 N2 both indicates, N1 principal quantum number of the lower energy state and N2 principal quantum number of the upper energy state or higher energy state, and lambda wavelength of the spectral line or wavelength of the electromagnetic radiation emitted by the electron when jumps from the higher to lower orbit. Now in this class we will discuss spectral series of hydrogen atom, spectral series. So generally a hydrogen atom is one of the simplest atom which contains a single electron, only single electron, and similar to that He plus, single ionized helium atom, or double ionized lithium atom, or triple ionized beryllium, and so on. They also contain only single electron. So hydrogen and hydrogen like atoms we can apply Bohr's model. So if you select only hydrogen atom, one of the simplest atom which contains only one electron, but the spectral lines of the hydrogen atom not single. Hydrogen atom contains only one electron, but the number of spectral lines are infinite. How it is possible? If take one some hydrogen gas, whenever some amount of light is passed through the hydrogen gas, or whenever some current is passed through hydrogen gas, so all the electrons will absorb the energy, they jump from the lower to higher orbits. So that is called excitation. But after within 10 to the power of minus 8 seconds, again de-excitation takes place. The electron jumps from higher orbit to the lower orbit. While returning back, electron emits energy in the form of electromagnetic radiation, nothing but a photon. So that can be called as a spectral line. But here, when electron jumps from first to, for example, a fourth orbit, while de-excitation, there are 6 transitions are possible. Electron may jump from fourth to first orbit, fourth to second orbit, fourth to third orbit, or third to second, third to first, or second to first. Total 6 transitions are possible. But in a hydrogen atom, each and every energy state having its own energy value, fixed value. For example, first orbit, minus 13.6 electron volt, second orbit, minus 3.4, third orbit, minus 1.51, and the last infinite orbit, 0. But generally, nth orbit means minus 13.6 by n square electron volt, one formula also given. So every energy state having a fixed energy value. For example, when electron jumps between any two fixed orbits, like a second to first orbit, so the difference of energy will be emitted. So for example, second orbit minus 3.4 electron volt, first orbit minus 13.6 electron volt, if you take a difference, 10.2 electron volt. So whenever electron jumps from second orbit to first orbit, always a fixed energy will be emitted. So no change. So 10.2 electron volt only will be emitted. For example, when electron jumps from 10th orbit to 9th orbit, also energy will be fixed. So all the energy orbits are having their own values, and the difference of any two orbits may take also fixed. That's why the transition of electrons also we can take first to second, first to third to second, or 10th to 8th. So the energy difference between two orbits will be always a fixed value you should take. Now here, when because of the transition of electrons from higher orbits to lower orbits, we are getting spectral lines. a group of all the spectral lines can be called as spectral series. So here we can discuss Lyman, Balmer, Paschen. So different spectral series we can discuss. What are spectral series means? A group of spectral lines. Spectral series meaning a group of spectral lines is called spectral series. Spectral lines means nothing but a spectral line means one electron jumps from the higher energy state to the lower energy state. Energy released in the form of electromagnetic radiation or photon, so which is called a spectral line. A group of all these spectral lines can be called as a spectral series. And to find or to analyze the spectral series, Balmer given one empirical formula. So means that the formula we know already, which is also called as a Rydberg formula. Rydberg formula for understanding of the spectral series is nothing but 1 by lambda is equal to, if it is a hydrogen atom, no need to write Z. Z value equal to 1. If any other atoms given, you should write a Z square into R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. If the given atom is hydrogen, we can put Z is equal to 1. Then 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square, you should write, which is called Rydberg formula for hydrogen atom. And in the previous class I have given the value of R also. So here Rydberg constant R is equal, there is a formula also, ME power 4 by 8 epsilon naught square into CH cube. It is a formula for Rydberg constant. The previous class already I have given formula also, the derivation of the wave number formula. Here mass of electron M, charge of electron E, absolute permittivity of free space epsilon naught, speed of the light c, and the Planck's constant h. By substituting all the values, we'll get the value 1.097. Still, if you want to write the value, we can write 37 also, into 10 to the power of 7 per meter. It is a value of Rydberg constant. In numericals, we can use up to 1.097. We can write into 10 power 7. We write. So in this formula, sometimes competitive exams they are asking a question. Instead of electron, one a hypothetical particle I want to choose, not electron. So instead of electron, I am choosing one imaginary or hypothetical particle having a double the mass of electron. So if you choose, for example, electron only revolving around the nucleus of hydrogen atom, we can apply this formula and we can use this value also. Instead of the electron, one hypothetical particle is revolving around the nucleus, but the mass of this hypothetical particle is a double that of the electron. Then how we can apply Bohr's atomic model? So in this formula, R is directly proportional to mass. Charge of the particle same as that of electron. Then we can write R is directly proportional to M. So then R1 by R2 is equal to M1 by M2 we can write. Here charge is a constant. Charge of electron and charge of the hypothetical particle we can take same. Then we can apply this formula. If for example mass of the hypothetical particle is a double the mass of electron, then in this formula you should write 2m. So 2m into e power 4. In Rydberg formula, what you should write? Whenever m is doubled, automatically r is also doubled. Here instead of r, you should write 2r. 1 by lambda is equal to 2r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. But for a hypothetical particle, mass is 4 times that of the electron. Then you should write m become 4. Here r also 4 times. Then 1 by lambda equal to 4r, you should write. Sometimes if a mass of the hypothetical particle and electron same, but charge is doubled. Charge is doubled. Then check here. R is directly proportional to e power 4. Should write r proportional to e power 4. That implies r1 by r2 is equal to e1 by e2 whole to the power of 4, you should write. But here mass of the hypothetical particle and the mass of the electron both are same. M is a constant. So sometimes a hypothetical particle double the charge of electron but same mass. Hypothetical particle double the charge of electron but having the same mass, is revolving around the nucleus. By applying a Bohr's model, find the wavelength. They asked a question. So here check whenever mass constant, but E is a double means here E plus E should write 2E. So 2E whole power 4. 2 power 4 is equal to 16. Then whenever R becomes 16, here also should write 1 by lambda is equal to 16 R should write. Into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. By substituting required n1 and n2 values, we can find lambda also. So for competitive exams, these two formulae important. That is important. Only for electron, no need to change. Whenever they ask the question, imaginary particle or one hypothetical particle, use this formula. That is important. It is a Rydberg formula. This Rydberg formula is one of the important empirical formula to understand the wavelength of the spectral lines. When electron jumps from the 10th to 4th orbit, how to find the wavelength? Or 4th to 1st orbit, how to calculate wavelength or frequency? So we can use this formula. Now we go for different spectral series. What are the different spectral series means? We have for a hydrogen atom, there are various spectral series. Types of spectral series of hydrogen atom. Types of spectral series of hydrogen atom means one is, you can write Lyman. In the name of the scientist only, we are giving a Lyman series. And the second one, Balmer series. So Balmer only given this empirical formula. So Balmer given this formula, Rydberg formula, Balmer series. And the third one, Paschen series. Paschen series. All the series came under the name of their scientists only generally. And next one, a Brackett series. Brackett series. And the fifth one, P fund or fund series. So in our regular syllabus it is given, and one more sixth also Humphrey series also there, but not necessary. So in our regular syllabus they given total 5 series. It is one of the important 5 marks question. Explain the or discuss the spectral series of the hydrogen atom. For every spectral series, when we will obtain the Lyman series or Balmer and so on, when we will obtain the particular series, and what is n1 value, n2 value, and also what is the least wavelength, what is the highest wavelength, and also to which part of the electromagnetic spectrum the particular series belongs, that you have to discuss. So electromagnetic spectrum means we are having a total 7 waves are there. Electromagnetic spectrum, if you take the spectrum produced by electromagnetic radiation, and if you analyze, we are getting a total 7 rays. First one nothing but called gamma rays. Gamma rays. Next one, ultraviolet rays, UV rays. Next, X-rays. So, sorry, gamma rays, and next X-rays. UV rays, ultraviolet. Visible light. Whatever the light we are seeing called as a visible light. Visible light having a wavelength from 400 nanometer to 750 nanometer. Next, infrared rays, IR. Next, microwaves. Microwaves. And also largest wavelength, nothing but called radio waves. So all these are the part of electromagnetic spectrum. Among all these rays, shortest wavelength, gamma rays. Shortest wavelength means highest frequency. And last, radio waves, highest wavelength or shortest frequency. So generally, among all these rays, if you check the Lyman series, it generally belongs to ultraviolet region. So Lyman series belongs to ultraviolet region. It is having a wavelength from nearly 10 nanometer to 400 nanometer. So 10 to 400 nanometer UV region. It is, and the next Balmer series belongs to visible region, like around 400 nanometer to, it is equal to 750 nanometer. And Paschen series belongs to infrared region, lesser wavelength of infrared region. And Brackett series belongs to also infrared region, middle region nearly. And P fund series also belongs to infrared, but higher wavelength side it belongs. So all these we'll discuss. Now put the first one side reading a Lyman series. For every series, sir, what is the definition or when we'll obtain the series? What is the Rydberg formula for the series? What is the shortest wavelength? What is the longest wavelength? And also, to which part of the electromagnetic spectrum the series belongs? We should learn. That's important. For 5 marks also, it is important question. First one, Lyman series. If you learn Lyman series carefully, remaining spectral series also similar model. Lyman series. So in the name of the scientist Lyman, we got this spectral series only. Whenever some amount of energy is supplied to the hydrogen atom, all the electrons in the hydrogen atom get excited, and at the time of the de-excitation, the electrons jumps from the higher orbits to lower orbits. So whenever electron jumps from the higher orbit to the first orbit of hydrogen atom, then that spectral series can be called as Lyman series. So for example, when electron jumps from second orbit to first orbit, third orbit to first orbit, fourth to first, tenth to first, and also infinite to first, then the obtained spectral series can be called Lyman series. So here we can write the spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from higher energy orbit to the first orbit or first orbit. The spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to first orbit is called Lyman series. So here, what are the first and second lower and higher orbits means we can write N1 value, we can write 1. Always electron has to jump from the higher to only first orbit. That's why N1 you should write 1. But what is a higher orbit here means N2, maybe 2, 3, 4, and so on. Last we can write up to infinite. So N1 always indicates lower energy orbit, and N2 is equal to upper energy state. So when electron jumps from the second to first, third to first, fourth to first, and so on, infinite to first, then the obtained series is called Lyman series. And we can write a Rydberg formula for Lyman series also. 1 by lambda is equal to general formula R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. It is a general formula. So from this formula, I'll substitute the value. 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 1 square. In place of the N1, I'm writing a 1 minus 1 by N2 place, I'll put N. Minus 1 by N square, or simply we can write 1 minus 1 by N square. If a least orbit is a 2, we should put here 1 by 2 square. If a least orbit is a 3, we should write 1 by 3 square. But a higher orbit, always I am taking a N2 is equal to N. So N1 is equal to 1, and N2 place I am writing a N. It is a Rydberg formula. And the Lyman series belongs to Lyman. If you calculate the wavelength of the Lyman series, it belongs to ultraviolet region of electromagnetic spectrum. It belongs to UV region of electromagnetic spectrum. So just now I mentioned already, electromagnetic spectrum contains various regions. In that ultraviolet region, nothing but it is having a wavelength higher than X-rays but lesser than visible light. So it is having a wavelength ranges from 10 nanometer to nearly 10 nanometer to up to 400 nanometer. So Lyman series also having a values from 10 to should write 400 nanometer. For example, when an electron jumps from infinite orbit to the first orbit, whenever electron jumps from infinite orbit to the first orbit, we'll get the value least wavelength, shortest wavelength we'll get Lyman series. So that's also called as a series limit. How to calculate? For shortest wavelength, shortest wavelength is also called as a series limit. Shortest wavelength also, remember this word carefully, shortest wavelength also called a series limit. Why it is important means sometimes the numerical may be asked 5 marks. Find the shortest wavelength of Lyman series. If they ask a question, find the series limit of Lyman series. So nothing but shortest wavelength only. But how to calculate means N1 we should take 1. And N2 value you should take infinity. Any spectral series given, Lyman, Balmer, Passion, Bracket or Fund, whatever given, always if you want to calculate the shortest wavelength, N2 value must be infinity only, no change. But N1 value may change. Lyman series, N1 equal 1, Balmer, N1 equal 2, Passion, N1 equal 3, and P bracket 4, and P fund, N1 equal to 5 should take. Now, I'll substitute these two values in Rydberg formula. Therefore, from the formula, 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 1 square minus 1 by, here N2 means infinite, should write infinity square. So something by infinity is equal to 0. Therefore, 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 is equal to nothing but R only. 1 by lambda is equal to R. That implies lambda is equal to 1 by R. We should take a lambda is equal to 1 by R. We know already Rydberg constant value. I'll substitute and I'll calculate here. Which is equal to 1 by 1.09737 into 10 to the power of 7. So calculate this value. 1 by and 10 power plus 7 I want to take to numerator. 10 to the power of minus 7 will get in meters. 0.91157. 0.91157 into 10 power minus 7 meter, or you can write the value lambda is equal to 911.57 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. But 10 power minus 10 meter is equal to 1 angstrom unit. That is equal to 911.557, or your choice. You may round off this one to 6 also. 57 angstrom unit. It is the shortest wavelength of the Lyman series. So sometimes only this may be asked for 5 marks numerical. Calculate the shortest wavelength or series limit of Lyman series. That is the only question. So we have to take the values and we have to calculate up to here. It is a fixed value. Whenever electron jumps from infinite orbit to first orbit, there will be no change. Always it is a fixed value. Next, how to calculate the longest wavelength of the Lyman series? For longest wavelength, so for shortest wavelength we have taken N1 equal to 1, N2 equal to last value infinite. But whenever if you want to calculate the longest wavelength, N1 equal to 1 same, Lyman series. But N2 equal to immediate value should take 2. Whenever electron jumps from second orbit to first orbit, we'll get the longest wavelength. So N1 is equal to 1. And N2 is equal to, should take a 2. When electron jumps from the second orbit of the hydrogen atom to the first orbit of hydrogen atom, we will get the longest wavelength of the Lyman series. Use the Rydberg formula and calculate. 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by N1 square means 1 by 1 square minus 1 by N2 square means 1 by 2 square. That is equal to R into 1 by 1 square equal to 1 minus 1 by 4 you should write. 1 minus 1 by 4 is equal to 3 by 4. That equal to 3 R by 4, which is equal to 3 R by 4. 1 by lambda. But lambda is equal to 4 by 3 R you should write. Right, 4 by 3 R. I'll substitute the value here. That is equal to 4 divided by 3 into 1.09737 into 10 to the power of 7. So exactly, no need to write 37 value. Write up to 1.097 enough. Now calculate. that equal to 4 by 3 again divided by 1.097 into 10 to the power of 7. 4 by 3, 4 by 3 divided by 1.4. I'll write here value. So 4 divided by 3, 1.33 will get. 4 divided by 3 means again divide the value with 1.09737. We get 1.21543. So 1.2154 will get the value. If you want to adjust one or two digits, we'll get the value 1215.4 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter, which is equal to 1 angstrom. So longest wavelength of the Lyman series 1215.4 angstrom, shortest wavelength is equal to 911.57 angstrom. So what is the range of the Lyman series values means? Lambda lies between approximately 911.57 or nearly 6 angstrom unit to it up to 1215.4 angstrom unit. So nearly we can write 911.57 or 912, approximately 912 angstrom unit to 1215 angstrom. If you want to write the same value in nanometer, you should write 91.15 nanometer to, it is equal to 121.5 nanometer also right, anyone. So it is about Lyman series. So check once again. So generally the Lyman series obtained when an electron jumps from higher energy orbit to the first orbit of hydrogen atom, you'll get this spectral series. And for this spectral series, least value means N1 equal to 1 and a higher energy state N2 equal to 2, 3, 4 and so on infinite. And if you write the Rydberg formula, 1 by lambda equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. But N1 equal to 1, N2 equal to N. Therefore, 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 1 square minus 1 by N square. And after getting this value lies in UV region of the electromagnetic spectrum. So already I said it belongs nearly 10 nanometer to approximately 400 nanometer. That's why this wavelength also belongs to the UV region. So Lyman series always belongs to the ultraviolet region of the electromagnetic spectrum. So this wavelength is higher than X-rays, but lesser than visible light. Now, and for calculating shortest wavelength or series limit of Lyman series, we should take always N1 equal to 1 and N2 equal to infinity. By substituting the Rydberg formula, we'll get the value 911.57 angstrom unit. For getting the longest wavelength of the Lyman series, we should take N1 equal to 1 and N2 equal to 2. On substituting the values, we'll get 1215.4 angstrom unit. That is about Lyman series. Now, second one, Balmer series. Second spectral series is nothing but a Balmer. Similar model we have to calculate Balmer series. But in Balmer series also, check when we'll get Balmer series generally. When electron jumps from higher orbits to second orbit. So the spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to the second orbit is called Balmer series. So Lyman series higher orbit to first orbit. But a Balmer series higher orbit to the second orbit. Higher to the second orbit you should take. So the spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to the second orbit is called Balmer series. So it is named after the scientist Balmer. That's why we called as Balmer series. So in case of the Balmer series, what are n1 into possible values means n1 is equal always to 2. Least orbit is equal nothing but you should take a 2 only. But a higher orbits you may take, n2 is equal to greater than 2 you should take. 3 comma 4, 5, 6 and so on you should take up to infinite. So higher value is equal you should take infinity. But least value is equal always you should take 2. If you want to write the Rydberg formula, from Rydberg formula we can write 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by 2 square. N1 place I am writing a 2, but n2 place I am writing a n minus 1 by n square. So Rydberg formula 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by n square. Here I am using this formula for a hydrogen atom. That's why I am not writing a z value. Only z equal to 1 you should take. But after calculating it belongs to which part of the electromagnetic spectrum means visible region. Balmer series belongs to the visible region of electromagnetic spectrum. So generally visible region having a wavelengths 400 nanometer to 750 nanometer or 4000 angstrom unit to 7500 angstrom unit you should write. So it belongs to visible region of electromagnetic spectrum. That is only. Now how, but here it is having a different spectral series names H alpha, H beta, H gamma and also H delta, various spectral lines also there. Now I'll write for shortest wavelength how to calculate means I'll write N1 is equal to right to N2 equal to infinity. When electron jumps from higher orbit to lower orbit generally Balmer series. But for getting a series limit, N2 must be infinite. But electron has to jump to only second orbit you should take. Now I'll substitute here. From Rydberg formula, 1 by lambda equal to r into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by infinity square. That equal to r by 4 will get. R by 4. To get lambda value you should write 4 by r. Here also we have to divide this value with the 4. Divide this one 4 divided by 1.097. That is called 3.6463 into 10 to the power of minus 7 meter. Or we can write this value 3646.3 into 10 power minus 10 meter. So which is equal to 3646.3 angstrom. That is a series limit of the Balmer series, least value. So this line is also called as H alpha line. When electron, So it is only the series limit or shortest wavelength of the Balmer series. So less than this wavelength not possible. That is only least value. But I'll calculate longest wavelength. I'll check here how to find longest wavelength of the Balmer series. Second one, for longest wavelength. For longest wavelength. I'll take here N1 is equal to 2. Whereas N2 is equal, I'll take immediate value 3 you should take. N1 is equal to 2 and N2 is equal to 3. Again use the Rydberg formula and calculate. 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by 3 square you should write. 1 by 2 square means 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3 square is equal to 1 by 9. That equal r into 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9. Take LCM and simplify this one. So 9 minus 4 is equal to 5 r by 36. 5 r by 36 or lambda is equal to 36 by 5 r. Lambda is equal to 36 by 5 r. Now I'll substitute here value 36 divided by 5 into 1.09737 into 10 to the power of 7. First divide 36 by 5. 36 divided by 5. Obtained value again divide with 1.09737. 6.5633. Or you may write the value 6563.3 into 10 power minus 10. So 10 power minus 10 is equal to angstrom. Should write. So longest wavelength of the Balmer series 6563.3 angstrom, or if you want to say nanometer, 656.3 nanometer, and the least value called 364.6 nanometer we can write. So the range of the Balmer series in the visible region generally, or maybe less than that visible region also, 3646.3 angstrom unit to it is equal to 6563.3 angstrom unit. That is the range of the Balmer series, wavelength of the Balmer series. It is a Balmer series. Once again, when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to the second orbit, then the obtained spectral series is called as Balmer series. For Balmer series, N1 is equal to 2 and N2 is equal to 3, 4, 5 and so on infinite. And Rydberg formula 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by N square. And it belongs to the visible region of the electromagnetic spectrum. And for finding a series limit or shortest wavelength, N1 equal to 2 and N2 equal to infinity, and you'll get the value 3646.3 angstrom unit. For finding the longest wavelength, N1 equal to 2, N2 equal to 3, and the wavelength value 6563.3 angstrom. That is the range. But here I'll give one more important point. Here only, sometimes in calculations they may ask, calculate the wavelength of H alpha line of the Balmer series. H alpha line means what you should calculate. If taking case of the Balmer series, I'll take a different values like this. These are the energy states or energy orbits I'll use here. It is equal, for example, N is equal to 2, second orbit. N is equal to 3. N is equal to 4. N is equal to 5. And N is equal to 6. But this state will be N is equal to 1, which is called a ground state. The least orbit can also be called as a ground state. That is nothing but N is equal to 1 you should take. Now, when an electron jumps from third orbit to the second orbit, so always for Balmer series, the least value 2. When electron jumps from the third orbit to second orbit, so this obtained spectral series line can be called as a H alpha line. So whenever they ask a question, calculate the wavelength of H alpha line, then what you should take N1 and N2 values? N1 equal to 2 and N2 equal to 3 you should take. So you can write here for H alpha, right, this is important. For a H alpha line, for a H alpha line, we can write N1 is equal to 2, comma N2 is equal to 3. N1 is equal to 2, N2 is equal to 3. For a H beta line, for a H beta, here you should write when electron jumps from fourth orbit to the second orbit you should take. Whenever electron jumps from the fourth to second you should take H beta line. So for this one, N1 is equal to 2, N2 is equal to 4 you should take. N1 is equal to 2, N2 equal to 4. If they ask you the question, calculate the wavelength of H beta line, we need to use N1 is equal to 2 and N2 equal to 4. Similarly, for H gamma line, H gamma line, so N1 is equal to, we should take 2 only, but N2 is equal to, we need to take 5. So when electron jumps from the fifth orbit to the second orbit, we'll get the value H gamma. H gamma. Similarly, when electron jumps from the sixth orbit to the second orbit, that can be called H delta, H alpha, H beta, H gamma, and H delta. So if they ask you the question in either in a competitive exams or in a PU exam, you should use this one. For a H delta line, N1 is equal to 2, N2 is equal to, should take 6. So this point important for calculations, both for a PUC as well as competitive exams. Important, remember this one. Now we'll go for the next spectral series, Paschen series. Next one, Paschen series. Third one. Paschen series. So generally, when we will obtain a Paschen series, least orbit must be 3, you should take. So when an electron jumps from higher orbit to third orbit, you should take. So the spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from, when an electron jumps from higher orbit to third orbit. The spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to third orbit is called Paschen series. Write simple definition here. The spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to the third orbit is called the Paschen series. So here N1 must be always equal to 3. But N2 is equal to greater than 3, means 4, 5, 6 and so on you should take. So for this spectral series, N1 is equal to 3, whereas N2 is equal to 4, 5, 6 and so on we can write up to infinite. Up to infinity we can take. And if you write the Rydberg formula here, we know 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. It is a formula, Rydberg formula. But already we know N1 is equal to 3 and N2 equal to, you should write N. Therefore, 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 3 square minus 1 by N square, you should write. So N1 place I am using a 3 and N2 place I am writing a N. It belongs to which part of the electromagnetic spectrum, means infrared region. It belongs to, so I am writing a short form as IR, infrared region of electromagnetic spectrum. So already we know infrared region having the wavelength higher than the visible light but lesser than microwaves. So more than the visible light, it is having a more than visible light but less than the microwaves, that is infrared region. But how to calculate the shortest wavelength or series limit here also? I'll calculate first shortest wavelength of the Paschen series or series limit. Shortest wavelength or series limit. So remember this word carefully. Sometimes in exam they may ask a series limit, but sometimes they may use directly shortest wavelength based on the question you have to take. So I'll write here N1 is equal to 3, but N2 value is equal to always infinite for finding a shortest wavelength. Now use the Rydberg formula. 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 3 square minus 1 by infinity square. But something by infinity is equal to 0. Therefore, it is equal to only R by 9. So 1 by lambda is equal to R by 9. Or lambda is equal to, right, 9 by R. So that is the shortest wavelength of the Paschen series. But I'll calculate still. Lambda is equal to 9 by, we know the value of Rydberg constant R, 1.09737 into 10 to the power of 7. So if you take 10 to the power of 7 to numerator, it becomes 10 power minus 7. Now you should divide 9 by 1.097. 8.20419 into 10 power minus 7. If you adjust 3 digits, we'll get the value 8204.19 angstrom unit. That is the shortest wavelength of the Paschen series or series limit of the Paschen series. So it is one important 5 marks numerical for POC. If they ask you the question, calculate the series limit of the Paschen series. First, you should write the data, Rydberg formula, and then substitution, calculation, last result with the unit. Again, I'll calculate the longest wavelength of the Paschen series. For a longest wavelength, I'll take the values of N1 and N2. N1 is equal to 3. For any wavelength they asked for Paschen series, always N1 equal to 3, fixed value. But N2 we should select. N2 is equal to, we should take 4. When electron jumps from the 4th orbit to 3rd orbit, we'll get the wavelength is the longest, but energy is least, or frequency also least. Now we'll take 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 3 square minus 1 by 4 square. Simplify this one, we'll get the wavelength value. That is equal to R into 1 by 9 minus 1 by 16. That equals 7R by 144. We'll get 7 into R by 144. 16 minus 9. 7R by 144. We'll get R. Lambda is equal to 144 by 7R. I'll substitute still R value also. 144 divided by 7 into 1.09737 into 10 to the power of 7. So first you should divide 144 divided by 7. And again obtained value you should divide with 1.09737. 18.75244 into 10 to the power of minus 7, or write the value 18752.2 should write. So three digits I'm adjusting here, that equal 18752.24 angstrom unit. 18752.4 angstrom, that is equal to the longest wavelength of the Lyman series, Paschen series. So range means it lies between 8204.19 angstrom unit to 18752.4 angstrom unit. That is the range of the Paschen series. So generally this value lies to infrared region of electromagnetic spectrum. That is about the Paschen series. Next, fourth one, bracket series. So it is also named after the person Brackett. In the name of the scientist Brackett only, we got a Brackett series. But when we'll get a Brackett series means generally when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to fourth orbit, you should take. So Lyman higher to first orbit, Balmer higher to second orbit, and a Paschen higher to third orbit, but a Brackett higher to fourth orbit. So the spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from higher orbit to the fourth orbit is called Brackett series. When the spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to the fourth orbit is called Brackett series. And here we can write the values of lower and higher values. Least orbit number, here N1 is equal to 4, we can write N1 equal to 4, but a higher values, N2 values 5, 6, 7 and so on up to infinity we can write. So n1 is equal to 4, n2 equal to 5 comma 6 comma 7 and so on up to infinite orbit. So we can write a Rydberg formula also. From Rydberg formula, 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. N1 place I am substituting 4. So 1 by 4 square, n2 place I will put n, therefore 1 by n square. That is a Rydberg formula. And if you calculate and if you analyze, it also belongs to infrared region of the electromagnetic spectrum. So it is a lesser wavelength side, but it is having a middle wavelength almost. So it belongs to infrared region of electromagnetic spectrum. And how to calculate the least and highest wavelength means, here you should take n1 is equal to 4. For shortest wavelength of the bracket series, we should take n1 equal to 4 and n2 equal to infinite. Here write 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by 4 square minus 1 by infinity square. 1 by 4 square minus 1 by infinity square. That equal to r by 4, 4 is 16. Or lambda is equal to, take reciprocal, that equal to 16 by r you should write. Lambda is equal to 16 by r. Now write this value here. That is equal to 16 by 1.09737. That is equal to 14.5852 into 10 to the power of minus 7 meter. Or if you adjust it to 3 digits decimal places, we'll get a 14,000, we'll get value 14,585.2 angstrom unit. That is the shortest wavelength of the bracket series. Same model, find the longest wavelength of the bracket series. We need to take n1 is equal to 4, n2 equal to 5. N1 is equal to 4, N2 equal to 5. Substitute here values. Rydberg formula, 1 by lambda equal to r into 1 by 4 square minus 1 by 5 square. That equal to 1 by 16 minus 1 by 25. That equal to 25 minus 16 is equal to 9r divided by 25 into 16, 400 should write here. Take a reciprocal, that equal to 400 by 9r or 400 by 9 into this value should write. That is equal to 40. First, 400 by 9 and divided by, check once again, 400 by 9, 400 divided by 9 equal to something we'll get, and again divided by 1.09737. 40.5008 into 10 power minus 7. Now adjust the digits. 40,500 405,000.8. So check once again values. Once again, recheck the value also. 400 by 9. 400 divided by 9 divided by 1.09737, 40.5008 or 40,500.8 angstrom unit. That is about bracket series. And the last one, P fund or fund series. Fifth one, last one. Fifth one, P fund series or simply fund series. So check here, when we'll get fund series means, or P fund series means, the spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to fifth orbit, you have to take. So whenever electron jumps from any higher orbit of the hydrogen atom to the fifth orbit of the hydrogen atom, we can obtain the P fund series. So we can write N1 is equal to 5, but N2 equal to 6, 7, 8 and so on you'll get. So the spectral series obtained when an electron jumps from higher orbit to the fifth orbit is called P fund series. And we can write a principal quantum number here, N1 equal to 5, N2 equal to 6, 7, 8 and so on, infinite we can write. If we write a Rydberg formula for a hydrogen atom, 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. I'll take N1 is equal to 5. But N2 equal to, should write N. So 1 by 5 square minus 1 by N square. After calculating the wavelength of this spectral series, if you analyze, it also belongs to the infrared region of the electromagnetic spectrum. So P fund series belongs to IR region of the electromagnetic spectrum of higher wavelengths. And if we calculate the shortest wavelength or series limit, we should take N1 equal to 5, N2 equal to infinity. Then 1 by lambda equal to R into 1 by 5 square minus 1 by infinity square you should take. That is equal to R by 25. If take a reciprocal, we'll get a lambda is equal to 25 by R. Lambda is equal to 25 by R. Now I'll substitute the value here. Should I 25 by R value, Rydberg constant value, 1.09737, divide this value, 22.7894, and on adjusting 3 decimal places, check what you'll get, 22,789.4 angstrom unit. That is the shortest wavelength of the P fund series. And what is the longest wavelength? For that you may take N1 equal to 5, N2 equal to 6. N1 equal to 5, N2 equal to 6 for longest wavelength. So 1 by lambda equal R into 1 by 5 square minus 1 by 6 square. 1 by 5 square minus 1 by 6 square. And check the value. If you substitute, that equal to R into 1 by 25 minus 1 by 36. That equal to 36 minus 25 equal 11R. 11R by 900. Or lambda is equal to 900 by 11R. That equal to 900 divided by 11 into 1.09737 into 10 power minus 7. So 10 power 7 should write. 74.5835 into 10 to the power of minus 7 meter. Or if you adjust 3 decimal places, 74,583.5 into 10 power minus 10 meter. But 10 power minus 10 meters equal to 1 angstrom unit. So that is the longest wavelength of the P fund series, and the shortest wavelength equal 22,789. So these are the total 5 spectral series. But in an exam, no need to calculate all these values. If they ask a 5 marks question, explain the spectral series of hydrogen atom. Write a definition, N1 into values. It belongs to which part of the electromagnetic spectrum and the Rydberg formula. No need to calculate these values. But all the 5 series I calculated, longest to shortest, total 10 calculations I made. So indirectly you solved 10 problems for PUC also. That's important. So tomorrow class we'll discuss energy level diagram and also how de Broglie explained Bohr's postulate. Okay, thank you. Revise all these concepts.